restore regions in Turkey and Syria that were ravaged by earthquake earlier this year. Jarius Basir is playing an oud, a traditional Middle Eastern stringed instrument. He's one of several musicians taking part in a benefit concert at Aeolian Hall Saturday evening. Proceeds from the event will go to the International Red Cross to help provide relief to those in Turkey and Syria after a devastating earthquake in February. The event, which gets underway at 7 on Saturday, will feature a variety of artists who are giving their time and talent.
I have personal reasons, and I have human reason, compassionate reason. So I feel with my fellow humans, and when there's time to volunteer your time and talent that God gave us, so I would love to do that.
It's funny, you know, musicians were some of the most impacted during COVID, and you know, having nothing to begin with, like a lot of them really struggle, and yet they're the first ones to step up to the plate to help with things. I find this such a inspirational, aspirational thing about our community and the arts in general.
It was about 3 months ago, the Red Cross approached me and asked if the Aeolian would do a benefit concert for this terrible tragedy. And I just want to remind everybody, so in Syria, we had 8,476 people die and over 14,500 were injured in Syria. Among the dead included 2,153 children, 1,524 women. The Syrian Ministry of Health recorded over 2,248 earthquake-related deaths and 2,950 injuries in government-held areas, most of which were in the governorates. In the rebel-held areas, at least 4,547 people died and 2,200 others were injured. The Syria Network of Human Rights stated 73 medics, 5 media personnel, 67 workers in humanitarian agencies, and 4 civil defense personnel were amongst the dead. The Syrian Observatory for Human Rights said additional dead were buried before being registered, and some victims died in hospitals. Syria National Earthquake Center said the earthquake is the biggest earthquake recorded in its operational history. In Turkey, there were 50,783 deaths, 297 missing, 107,204 injured across 11 of the 17 affected provinces of Turkey. At least 15.73 million people and 4 million buildings were affected. About 345,000 apartments were destroyed. More than 2 million residents in affected provinces were evacuated to nearby provinces, including Mersin, Antalya, and Mardin. More than 20% of Turkey's agricultural production was affected. The United Nations said crops, agricultural fisheries, aquaculture, rural infrastructure were heavily damaged. At least 516 university buildings were affected, of which 106 were heavily damaged. So you can imagine this is going to take decades to kind of slightly recover and rebuild from. We are compelled to try to do something about that tonight, right? By the way, my name is Clark. I'm the director here. I want to just say that tonight is only possible because we have these amazing musicians in our community that at the drop of a hat will come and perform to raise money for causes. And you know, during the pandemic, musicians were amongst the hardest hit in our, and you know, economically, of course. I had a chance to talk to musicians all across North America during the pandemic, and some of the stories were so devastating. People lost their homes and vehicles and health plans in the United States, things like that. So I'm just really proud of my community and proud of all of you for stepping up to the plate to be here as well. I want to thank the volunteers that are at your service tonight at the bar, ushering. We are mostly a volunteer-run organization. We have 6 full-time staff. That's it. 2 facilities, so you can imagine. Tonight I know we have some of our board here, and I really appreciate your support through these last few years. Couldn't have done it without you. So tonight is a variety show, and we're going to start out with a local musician, a friend of mine. She won one of the musicians in the group won our songwriting competition, Tara Dunphy, and I'd like you to join me in welcoming to the stage Maggie's Wake.
Thank you. new album, which will be hopefully out in the fall, our first album. And it's all about living in the moment, living in the life that you're made, or that you have made with your family, with your friends, instead of always kind of looking towards what you're hoping for. Live right now, because this is all we know that we have, and it's called The Life You Made.
This is